Hello everyone, welcome to MJ Hobby Corner. I'm MJ, and just a quick update before I begin the topic for this video. Julie is home and she is recovering. We had a scare. She had to go back to the hospital again last week, but she's home now and she is recovering. So as soon as we can, as soon as she's better, we will do an MJ Hobby Talk together and you guys can see her and she can update you guys. So but she is recovering, and thank you for all your support and all your good wishes during this time. All right, and now the topic for today's video is unboxing Alliance Centaurs 172 scale. That, and I have a couple of things to show you guys. All right, and here we are, Alliance, Dark Alliance Centaurs, and this is by the company Alliance, and these are 172 scale. And one thing that attracted me is these are very Greek-like. If we look in the back, okay, and this is a little bit of what you get in the box. There are 6 different poses and 24 figures. Now, I already clipped out a couple of the centaurs because I like to show them out of the sprues as well, and we'll just talk a little bit about setting them up. Okay, so that's the sprue that I cut, and I'll just have a couple of little things to say about that, and then we're good to go. All right, so you get 4 sprues. All of your diversity of poses is in one sprue, and the rest are all copies. Okay, now as you will see, good detail on these guys, I have to say. There's a little bit of flash right here, which has to be cut and trimmed. And I actually used my cuticle scissors and got these clipped really nicely. But you can use miniature clippers, whatever you have available. And basically, the biggest thing is getting them off these big, fat sprue bits here. But not too bad. You get an archer, you get, it looks like a spear, battle axe, warhammer, not bad. And again, there is some cleaning. I see some cleaning, some mold lines right here in the center, which are really obvious. And that's true of some Alliance figures. But all in all, guys, all in all, not bad. I really like the centaurs. I like their the way they look. They really have that mythological, you know, age of antiquity look to them. And these are very important. Look at that guy. I like that guy. These are very important because I didn't have a lot of fantasy cavalry. And these guys could definitely... Look at that. I love his facial expression. And these will definitely be great in a variety of different games that I'm planning, including Broken Legions. They have centaurs of Gods and Magic. You know, and basically any game that we play, Dragon Rampant, anything like that, where we can create our own armies. So, all right, so there you go. These are the Alliance Centaurs. I was really, really waiting for these. They'll need a little bit of cleaning. I really like this guy. This guy looks really cool. The Spartan helmet and the armor. Very, very cool. All right, so we'll be painting these. All right, let's take a look at a couple of centaurs. So you get 24 of these guys. And let's just go see. So these are the 2 that I've clipped. Okay, and I used this plastic material from an old DVD case, CD case. It's a very soft plastic for like... It was a DVD case. It was an old movie case. And it's very soft plastic, and I just cut it and cut it to the length that I need, and then I add my, I glued my sandpaper thing there, and then I have another little trick that I use for the base, and then these get glued. And I use a combination of tacky glue and cyanoacrylate glue, like this Loctite, and it reacts together and really glues hard as well. So, but I mean, you can use a variety of different materials, and if you're experienced in these scales or in these models, more than likely you have your own techniques for doing this stuff. This is the way that I do it. So not bad. The only thing is the sprue. With this sprue, I actually used a knife, a heavier knife, and kind of clipped my centaurs out, and then I did filing with another piece of filing paper and just made sure that everything here is filed and that the model stands on its own, and then it's ready to be glued, and then these guys will be ready for painting. All right, here are a couple of the Roman cavalry. These are already base coated in a brown, and I'm going to be painting these. I have about I have 10 of these that I'm going to be painting, and this is from the last unboxing that I did. But here is the kind of the size comparison. Okay, so very cool. Okay, so the base of the centaur is textured, and you have to use this technique with a lot of caution. Please, please do not inhale any of the plastic, the little smoke or whatever that comes out of burning plastic. Please don't ever wear a mask, work in an area that is ventilated, and because it's really not worth it. All right, now this is a very simple technique that textures the base, and I don't have to use any pastes or anything else, and then I just give the whole base and the sandpaper base a good base coat, and that's it, you know. And I do some ink washing and dry brushing, add a little bit of whatever I want there, a little bit of flocking powder or whatever, and that's it, you know. Decorate the base with some plants, and he's good to go. So that's just a quick and dirty technique to get texture on the base, along with the sandpaper that I use. And here's an example of a ghostly minotaur, and there's the base. I used a soldering tool to really heat it up and deform it and make like this weird rock work. And I'm not finished with this figure yet. I got to give this figure a little more highlighting and all that. But the strange rock work is all done with the soldering tool. And there's another one. You can kind of see that. Okay. So that's it. You just have to be really careful with the models and stuff, and not to burn yourself and, you know, that sort of thing. But it's a cool technique. It's something different, you know. I've used this technique for a long time, so, you know, I'm comfortable with it, but that's it. So I am working on quite a few things. Here's my Anubis army. We're going to talk about that in a little bit, and then my Roman cavalry. All right, let me bring your attention to some of the stuff that I have here, because I'm working on quite a few things. Here is Set. And I just finished sculpting him. I'm still in the process of painting. But Set, I'm using in a, together with 172 scale armies, as sort of a giant manifestation of the god. Almost like a Clash of Titans kind of thing. And I am playing Of Gods and Mortals. And hopefully Julie will join me soon. I'm doing some solo war games on my Patreon. Okay, so he's pretty much done, and I have several other gods that I sculpted, and I will be sculpting a couple of gods, different gods next. Okay, I want to have quite a few in order that we can tell a story. Now, this is a 172 scale chariot that I'm working on, and this is a big heavy chariot. These guys are big, they are bigger than humans, these dog-like warriors, and in this case I'm using them both for Of Gods and Mortals, but I'm also using them in sort of their own army, like a desert knoll army. And this is the command chariot, the heavy chariot. And so now I'm going to sculpt a creature to pull it. Okay. And this is all done with cardboard and clay, super sculpy clay. There's the little round bingo chips that I use for the wheels. And what I'm going to do now is decorate it with green stuff. So there will be some green stuff bars going through. And that will complete the wheels. So the wheels are not finished yet. And then that's it. Then I just got to sculpt the creatures that will be pulling the chariot. And I have five chariots on the way. Here are the other four. And this is the way they begin. Very simple. Now I'm going to add the cardboard. And one thing that's been very helpful is this bakeable Sculpey glue. This stuff, I can cement the clay on there and then it can be baked, you know, or it can use a heat gun or anything like that. And yeah, the cardboard is okay as long as I'm not using really high temperatures. The cardboard is fine. And that's how I got this stuff here to harden and also the green stuff. So this is flexible wire, so if I need to modify it, I can for whatever creature is going to be pushing it. Now this army has about 20 infantry, so I'm going to paint some in different colors. So now there's going to be some modular chariot dudes. Those are the chariots right there. I'm going to finish them up. We'll have about five chariots, one command chariot, and then I'm going to sculpt some kind of big beastie for these guys. And altogether, I have 40 figures. So there's two more sprues, full sprues, 20 more figures in here. So I have plenty of infantry, and I can paint them different colors. Some of them will represent elite, and some of them will represent regular infantry. And then I have some which will go on the chariots. And I'm also gonna probably do a conversion and add a couple of necromancers to that army. Okay. So this way I can maybe throw in some undead with them if I want to. So that's pretty much it. That's my custom made Anubis army with the chariots that I'm now creating. And I'm very busy painting all of these things up so that I can get them ready for gaming. And the last thing I want to show you guys, and this one's funny because he's on the foam, he's already dried. This is a very simple kind of walker for the game In Her Majesty's Name, but this is for 172 scale. And I am not finished with this. This is still in the making. And just to give you guys an idea, there's the 172 scale Englishman. Now I'm going to be getting troops of the appropriate type. And this is going to be a British walker. And when I finish it and have it all painted up, you guys will see it. This will probably, all this stuff will probably show up in February's Scratch Builder Monthly. I'm going to be mentioning this machine that I'm making. And it's still not finished. I have all the cabling and all the details back here near the boiler. And I have the arm details and weapon details that are coming. But it's getting there. It's almost finished. And that's going to be for a new 172 scale army for In Her Majesty's Name. So like an alternate history steampunk kind of game. Okay. So there it is. There's my 172 scale stuff and a lot of projects that I'm finishing up. So, and I still have some of the clips from the Deep Wars game that Julie and I did right before she got sick. And I have those clips. And I think it's only like till turn two or three, something like that. So I may just cook up a video with these clips, maybe add a little bit of post-game talk or something, and then just put it out. You guys can see the table and everything. And then in the future, we'll have a complete Deep Wars game because I do have some undersea projects that are coming. So keeping busy, guys. And that was my 172 scale projects. And there's more. There's a lot more coming. So I'll have a lot more to show you guys. And if you want to support us, a lot of this stuff's going to be on Patreon. And some is going to be Patreon exclusive. So if you want to support us on Patreon, thank you. You can. If you want to support us by going on War Games Vault, I am getting February's edition of Scratch Builder ready. And I also have a couple of smaller documents that are coming out that'll cover a lot of these projects, okay? So if you want to support us that way, it certainly helps us out. And that's it, you know? And certainly here, you can share our stuff on YouTube, whatever you guys want. Thank you so much for your support. And now it's time to really get to work because I'm very busy and I hope to have a game. So pretty soon I got to clean all this up and I'm going to have a game for the channel and stuff for Patreon as well. So very busy for sure. Have a good one, guys, and we'll talk in the next video. Bye now.